Previously on Pat the NES Punk.
Allie, I'll make it up to you. What happened last time was a mistake. Gumshoe.
Oh, Gumshoe, how I hate thee. I've gotten some feedback from my Gumshoe review, and a few think that maybe it was my zapper that was causing me some problems with the gameplay. So I decided to try a few more zappers out, and then I'll decide if maybe I was a little bit too hard on Gumshoe the first time around.
Alright, time to find zappers. Okay, zapper. Do I really need this many advantages? Okay, here we go. What the? Alright, I'm giving Gumshoe another go with a new zapper. Maybe it was a messed up zapper that prevented me from really playing this well last time.
The first zapper is giving me a lot of the same issues. Some of the shots are not registering, and the accuracy is a bit off.
Whew, barely shot that one!
And the same results with the second zapper.
Alright, so there I shot the bottle, did not register the hit.
With a third zapper, I actually did better and got farther than I ever had before.
Woo! Oh my god! Okay, that was impossible! So as you saw, I did a little bit better on Gumshoe using a third zapper. So maybe it was the original zapper I was using that was causing some problems. And so yeah, with Gumshoe, it's still a tough game to play, but you... Allison's right. These games are turning me into a slob. Bathroom stinks.
Currently, the Wii Fit is all the rage. Why wouldn't it be if you have girls doing this with it? It's hard to even find in stores since it's always sold out, and unless you pay more for one on eBay, you're not really gonna get one.
Oh, Yoshi. If only there was some way I can get into shape. Or with video games. If only the NES had some sort of fitness pad that would require power to use it. A power pad.
The power pad is a pretty simple accessory. You have 12 pressure sensitive spots that you can either step or press in order to interact with the games. It was Nintendo's bright idea that people would actually exercise and play games at the same time, but the idea never really caught on back then. There were only a handful of games made for the power pad, and only three that were not sports related. The Short Order Eggsplode Multicart, Street Cop, and Dance Aerobics. Mine's not exactly in the greatest shape, as you can see. That shows how much I care about it. I'll be playing the first two games in this video, but I wouldn't be caught dead playing Dance Aerobics. I mean, come on. So it failed as a marketing idea, but can you actually get in shape using the power pad? Let's find out. First, we'll start with Short Order, which is the tragic tale of a failed romance between a pig and a mouse. Please, please, hold all that laughter and applause. In short order, you actually work at a fast food restaurant, and you have to put together burger orders for customers. What that amounts to is placing the ingredients of the burger in its proper order. It's really a glorified game of Simon, but using the power pad. Here comes our first customer. Aw, look at the mouse! You start with a bun and the customer will hop around on one of four different power pad button combinations, indicating the order that he wants the ingredients added to the burger. It's your job to repeat this pattern by jumping around on the power pad.
You have to jump with both feet and hit both at the same time. And I wasn't looking there, so I don't know what I have to do now for this burger. So I'm gonna guess.
This game is simple, but there is one drawback. If you happen to screw up the order, you don't start from the very beginning. It forces you to continue in the middle of the pattern. The problem with this is that it becomes trial and error, as it's difficult to figure out exactly where you screwed up and left off. Jeez, no reason to get that angry. Damn duck. Like a traditional game of Simon, if you successfully repeat the pattern, it will repeat, but adding one more step each time. This gets more challenging as the number of ingredients increases per round.
Alright, I'm making burgers!
Aw, there's the mouse eating his burger and getting fat and happy. Enjoy your stroke, have a nice day. So, does short order actually help you lose weight? Well, you are burning calories jumping around on the power pad, but looking at all these burgers and making them...
All it does is it makes me want to eat one!
Next is Eggsplode, which I actually prefer over Short Order. Eggsplode is a glorified game of whack-a-mole, where you have to stomp out the bombs that these foxes place in a henhouse.
It's a pretty simple game where you just mimic what's on screen, much like DDR before DDR even existed.
Now I think, usually, foxes would actually try to eat hens, not blow up their butts. But hey, I'm no zoologist. So while you stomp away, there's a couple of important things to track. Sometimes the foxes will lay down yellow bombs, which only have a couple of seconds before they blow up, so you really have to be quick. Also, some of the hens will lay eggs in the middle of the round, and you cannot crush these, or else you'll lose a life. Man, I could really go for an omelet. The problem is, you might step on and crush the eggs by accident, if you're trying to get over them and step on the bombs. Unless your legs are 7 feet long, this is probably gonna happen at least once. Later rounds get insane, look at this!
The problem happens sometimes because your mat starts slipping, and then you get screwed!
Overall, Eggsplode's pretty fun. The controls are responsive, and actually gives you a good little workout. Now we're on to Street Cop. Not too promising when it's using an Atari 2600 sound effect. In Street Cop, you have to capture criminals by beating them into submission. So you're in a park, and you have a map on the bottom which gives your location, as well as the criminal. You have to use the power pad to get close to the criminal in order to whack him. You use a controller as well as a power pad, but you only use the controller for the weapons. This wouldn't be a problem, but not only do you run on the power pad, but you also turn around and move your street cop up and down on the screen.
It's not intuitive which power pad button does what.
It should be simple, but it's actually very awkward when you try to do it. And you'll find yourself wasting a lot of time, especially when you're close to the criminal, and then he turns around and walks away, and you're kinda out of luck.
What am I doing?
Come on, move up and get him. Alright, move up. Turn around. Oh, he moved down. Move down. Why couldn't I use the directional pad to do this? Alright, I'm gonna smack him in the head. Oh man. Okay, I got him now. I think it would actually be more enjoyable right now if I ventured into the city to find my own criminals to beat up. And easier, I might add. Eat my nightstick. Here's some for you, Ginger. Okay, next we have Lewis we have to capture. Yes, Lewis. It sounds very intimidating. He pushed the cap down on the boy's head? How hardcore! So I immediately fall into a sewer, and I'm attacked by these mouse-cat hybrids. Okay, I'm trying to get out the door here. I'm hitting up, go up. Nothing's working, there's no way to get out of here. Ugh, this is lame. So Street Cop's a pretty mediocre game, but I think I got a good workout at least. Let's see how many pounds I've dropped from playing these three games. No, that can't be right.